able to see the program. So for those of you who are technologically inclined, you can just give up the programs so that other persons can get them. All right, God bless you.
So move it, man. You can go ahead. Need an XLR line.
You're gonna
need an XLR line. XLR line.
I keep this connected inside just in case.
Yeah, man, you have access to the Wi-Fi, so it's fine.
Okay.
Amen.
That camera is open. If you have an app, that can.
Good morning.
Yeah, man, I can connect it.
No worries. Can use it too.
Greetings to each one. Glad to be here and to be a part of this very special memorial celebration. First, my respect to the immediate Blair family, to the members of clergy, and ministering colleagues. Today we celebrate the life and legacy of the late Bishop Delbert Blair, a man who has built relationships and has left an impact on our lives and for many who are not here today. Speaking of legacy, a legacy, to me, a legacy is a life of example for others to follow. A long-lasting impact of events and actions that took place in the past of persons' lives to impact the lives of others. Legacy is a sum of personal values, accomplishments, actions that resonates with people around you. A living legacy is something that is not only for the history books or as a blockbuster movie. Your life story is what connects you to your community and makes you stand out among others and what makes you unique. It does not only give good family stories to tell, but portrays your life with a sense of unity and purpose. A legacy is different from an inheritance. An inheritance is your private affairs. No one has the right to know or ask you about. But your legacy is the positive impact your life has on others, on other people, your friends, your colleagues, and even strangers. And that's the impact late Bishop Delbert Blair left on all of us. I said to my friend, if there's one apostle I know in Jamaica would be Bishop Delbert Blair. We celebrate him today, and we are happy for the impact that he has left on our lives. Let me ask the praise and worship team to give us a song, and then we'll proceed from there.
In the presence of the Lord this morning. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Bless the Lord, oh my soul, and all that is within me. Bless his holy name. Oh, can we declare? Oh, we just our God. How great is his name. He's the greatest one, forever the same. He rolled back the water from the mighty Red Sea. He said, I lead you. Won't you trust me? How great is our God, how great is his name, he's the greatest one, forever the same. He rolled back the water from the mighty Red Sea. He said, I lead you, won't you trust him? He rolled back the water from the mighty Red Sea. He said, I lead you, won't you trust me? Oh, he rolled back the water from the mighty Red Sea. He said, I lead you, won't you trust me? He said, I lead you, won't you trust in me? Won't you trust in me? Yeah.
Hallelujah! Hallelujah!
Hallelujah! Well, ladies and gentlemen, it is my distinct pleasure and privilege to introduce to you the chairman for today's celebration, a man who knew the late Bishop Delbert Blair. He's the lead pastor for the Greater Palm Bay Church of God, Dr. Bishop Johnny Lewinson from Palm Bay, Florida. God bless you.
Bless the Lord, O my soul, and all that is within me, bless his holy name. This is a very special occasion that we are gathered here today in the presence of the Honorable Conrad Pitkin, Bishop Dr. Harold Blair, and his precious wife, Bishop Roy Green, Bishop Kessel Blair, Bishop Yvonne Blair. All the Bishop Leslie Blair. The immediate family with Dr. Tessa Blair and all the beloved saints who are gathered here today on this memorable occasion. We pause today to celebrate the life and the legacy for beloved change it for what? Our beloved Bishop Delbert Leslie Blair. First, he's a beloved, or was a beloved, husband, father, who is among the most selfless, and I repeat the word selfless, P pillars of the faith. He was an ardent church planter. He did not learn that when he got credentialed. I remember in the 50s, while we were younger, we didn't have gray hair at the time. And we used to go in St. Mary, a place called Wood Park. Bishop Yvonne Blair will remember Wood Park. And we would plant a church there, which is there until today. And you would never imagine that a person could be doing his scholastic activities and at the same time plant a church from scratch. I thank God that I knew him then. And I thank God that he served or to the end. He was a pastor, a father, a friend of all who ever came in contact with him. One of the things that I remember about him is that friendly, humble behavior of a man. And a person who made the ultimate sacrifice, he gave his life. Special requirement or request I'm going to make before we, as we enter into the program, if you have a phone, if you put it on silence or vibrate, so that we keep the honor of this wonderful man of God, so that we will have the service going on as the Lord would have it be. We are going to look to God in prayer at this time. I'm going to ask Bishop Kelly to lead us in prayer. Bishop Kelly.
Let us pray.
Praise the Lord.
Our Father and our God, how excellent is your name in all the earth. Your power fills the universe. We thank you for who you are. We thank you for where you are. We thank you for owning us. We thank you for the freedom that you gave us. As we gather here today, O God Almighty, to continue, Lord God, this great celebration of your Son, an ambassador, we thank you, dear Lord God, for this great privilege. We ask that, Lord God, as we go forward in this ceremony, that it will bring blessing and glory and honor to your majestic name. We ask you, Lord God, to lead. We ask you, dear God, to cover. We ask you that everything that's said today will be done to your honor and your glory. We pray, Almighty God, that you will touch down. We pray that the hearts of your people be blessed. That at the end of the service, you will be glorified. We will be edified, and the devil will be terrified. We thank you for your blood upon us today. In Jesus' name, amen.
Somebody praise God in the house. Amen and amen. Sister Brenda Richards will come with the reading of the word of the Lord. Sister Richards.
Good morning, everyone. Shall we praise the Lord?
Shall we glorify the Lord? Okay, let us stand for the reading of God's word. We'll be reading from 2 Timothy 4. If you have your Bibles, please find that. One more time, shall we praise the Lord? Shall we glorify the Lord? Indeed, he is worthy to be. Praise the Lord. I charge thee therefore before God and the Lord Jesus Christ, who shall judge the quick and the dead at his appearing and his kingdom. Preach the word. Be instant in season, out of season. Reprove, rebuke, exhort with all longsuffering and doctrine. For the time will come when they will not endure sound doctrine, but after their own lusts shall they heap to themselves teachers, having itching ears. And they shall turn away their ears from the truth, and shall be turned unto fables. But watch thou in all things, endure afflictions. Do the work of an evangelist, make full proof of thy ministry. For I am now ready to be offered, and the time of my departure is at hand. I have fought a good fight, I have finished my course, I have kept the faith. And I'll stop at verse 8, which says, henceforth there is laid up for me a crown of righteousness, which the Lord, the righteous judge, shall give me at that day, and not to me only, but unto all them also that love his appearing. This is a portion of the Lord's holy word, and we honor it by saying, thanks be to God.
The welcome comes to us from Bishop Dr. Joyce Bernard. Dr. Bernard.
Good morning, everyone. Can we just put our hands together and appreciate the Lord as we come into his house? God bless you so much. The pleasure is mine on behalf of the immediate family of Bishop, the late Bishop Delbert Blair, along with the planning committee of this function, to welcome you to this memorial service. We are more than happy to have you in the presence of the Lord as we celebrate and remember this great man of God. As we come, I pray that we will worship the Lord in the beauty of holiness, and that we will enjoy each other's presence. We will remember this man, and I had a little saying here that I must say. I hope that his spirit will resonate with us, his spirit of being a builder, his spirit of being a church planter, his spirit of being a great singer, an evangelist, his spirit of being a great husband and a father. God bless you as we worship together. We'd just love to recognize the presence of some of the people that are with us. We want to recognize the presence of Bishop the Honorable Conrad Picton, CD, JP, Costas Ratolerum of Montego Bay. Can we put our hands together and recognize him? Secondly, I want to recognize the presence of our bishop and founder and wife, Bishop Dr. Harold and Alma Blair. Could you stand here if there's somebody that will be here? Thank you. Thirdly, I would love to appreciate the and recognize the presence of the immediate family of the late Bishop Delbert Blair. If you're here, I know Sister Tessa is here. Can the others please stand? bless you. Bless you so much. To our moderator, Bishop Dr. Johnny Lewinson. Nice to have you in the house. Could you give him a hand, please? Bishop Reverend Robert Williams, who is representing the Bishop of the New Testament Church of God, Reverend Roy Notice. We're happy to have you, sir. The pastors and ministers that are present on the forum and in the audience, can you stand and take a bow, please, as we appreciate your being here. Pastor Maureen Stone Barrett, who is a member of the coordinating committee, can you stand and take a bow, please, Pastor Barrett. And to all the others, the congregation and the others who are here, we are so happy to have you. God bless you. Enjoy the morning. Love you much. Bye.
This is the time when we all can worship as we stand together and sing, "Great is thy faithfulness."
Thou changest not.
until I let you go.
Great is thy faithfulness. Great is thy faithfulness. Morning by morning, new mercies I see. All I have needed, thy hands have provided. Great is thy faithfulness. Lord God,
somebody. Hallelujah.
Great is thy faithfulness.
Blessed is
wonderful name.
We pause for tribute at this time. And then the first will be coming from Reverend Robert Williams from the Church of God. Reverend Williams.
Good morning, my brothers and sisters. To Bishop Dr. Harold Blair, Bishop Dr. Johnny Lewinson, Pastor Roy Green, Reverend Canute Reagan, Bishop the Honorable Conrad H. Pitkins, C.D., J.P. Costas, Rotelaria, other ministers of the gospel, deliverers, family members, brothers and sisters, I greet you all today in the mighty name of Jesus. Greetings. We are gathered to celebrate the life of one of God's choice servants. Thank God for the contribution he has made. And for this, we are celebrating his life today. I stand here representing the Bishop of Dr. Roy Notice, Administrative Bishop of Jamaica, Unity Testament Church of God, and he has sent his tribute. I will therefore be reading the tribute from Dr. Notice. And of course, he has a title bearing Bishop Dr. Blair, Delbert Blair. Unity Testament Church of God in Jamaica. has been blessed by the faithful leadership of numerous pastors and members throughout its history. Today, we gather to pay homage to one such stalwart, the late Bishop Delbert Blair. A year after his passing, We are reminded of the profound impact he had on the parish of Hanover and beyond. His tireless dedication and unwavering commitment to the church will forever be etched in our hearts and memories. His infectious zeal for worship ignited a fire in the hearts of many. Drawing them closer to God. His legacy as a compassionate shepherd and a tireless evangelist will continue to inspire future generations. to spread the gospel with fervor and conviction. Bishop Delbert Blair, our Blair's hard work and dedication to the New Testament Church of God and the Kingdom of God will never be forgotten. As we reflect on his life, we are confronted with the words of 2 Timothy chapter 4, verse 7 and 8. I have fought the good fight. I have finished the race. I have kept the faith. Now there is in store for me the crown of righteousness. Which the Lord, the righteous judge, will award me on that day. And not only to me, but also to all who have wed wife.
Bishop Blair devoted himself wholeheartedly to serving and nurturing God's people. Their selfless sacrifice of time, energy, and resources laid the foundation for growth wherever they served. In Hebrews chapter 6, verse 10, we find solace in knowing that God is not unjust. He will not forget your work and the love, you have shown to him.
And you have helped his people and continue to help them. As we remember Dr. Delbert Blair, we do so with hearts full of gratitude
for his enduring legacy of courage, service, and devotion to God. Though he may have departed from this earthly realm, his spirit lives on in the countless lives he touched and the seeds of faith he sowed. Let us honor his memory by continuing to spread the light of Christ and embodying the principles of love, compassion, faith that he so passionately exemplified. The New Testament Church of God salutes Bishop Delbert Blair. Thank you very much. God bless you.
The New Testament Church of God will do a group song at this time, because there is another activity going on in the church body. The combined choir is not able to sing today, but I do believe that this group that will sing will do justice to that. While we're preparing for them, I'd like to also ask if Reverend Ashman, who is a part of the ministerial fraternal, if he's here, we'd like for you to be recognized. And he is not here yet. I'd also like to let you know that the main organizer for this activity that we are doing today is Bishop Dr. Kenneth Regan. And I thank God for him, and he's right here now. They saw you before, but unless you grow here, could you please stand? Thank you, sir. Can I also recognize the other members of the Blair family? There are several members of the Blair family that's all over this congregation. Could you please stand so that we could also recognize you? All the Blairs, all the Blairs. Yes. Thank you, thank you, thank you so much. At this time, we're going to have a group song from the New Testament Church of God. I'd like to ask you to stand together with me as we receive the bishop. Bishop Dr. Harold Blair.
Thank you very much. Please be seated. I sat there and I thought, this is very painful for me, and he added a little more salt in the wound by asking you to stand. But by standing, you have been a source of strength for me to come here this morning. We are gathered here today in the memory of my brother, our brother, Delbert, so that together we may acknowledge and share both our joy in the gift that his life was to us. We share also the pain that his passing a year ago brings. In sharing the joy and the life, the pain together today, may we lessen the pain and remember more clearly the joy that his presence with us over the many years and his passing have brought. Time would not afford me to share with you one of the reasons or the reasons that I am standing here, not just as a brother, but I can recall that first of all, when my brother Delbert was asked to go out to Mount Peace right here in Hanover from Maryland, I was his pillion rider. He rides and guides the bicycle. I was the crossbar rider. And I had to hold the tilly lamp. We were like 5 miles away from home one night coming from Mount Peace. It was a Sunday night, and when we reached the bridge that separates Maryland from Jericho, the light went out. And when I say the lights went out, if you know what tilly lamps do when they're going out, pluck, 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 pluck. And my brother said, we have to do something about it. Let's pray. And this was now like 3 miles away from home. And he prayed and he said, you are the light of the world. Let this light continue to shine. And there were no more pluck, 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 pluck for 3 miles until we set foot in Maryland. He was a man of faith, great faith. And so after his graduation from Bible school, and he was assigned to Mount Stewart in Westmoreland, I was assigned to be his protector from the Hawks at the time. And you would understand that I say the Hawks because anytime you see a beautiful piece of meat as a hawk, you'll go after it. So Delbert was one of those attractive, or at that time, the most attractive Blair. Thank you. So we worked together until I was not only his protector, he became my mentor, and I was the mentee. And he guided me also into ministry. We traveled land, air, and sea to preach the gospel together. As I stand here on behalf of the Deliverance Evangelistic Association, let me say and make it categorically clear, it is highly possible that without Delbert Blair's intervention in the ministry 48 years ago, we would not be here in this building. You would not have heard of a deliverance ministry that has impacted the world. From day one, he was in it to win it. From day one, he was there to help guide the sailing of the ship. And the Deliverance Evangelistic Association give thanks to Almighty God for the contribution he made for the setting up of this ministry. He directly, individually started this church. He started the Dean's Valley Church. Oh, good. We were together in the setting up of the Savlamar Church and of the Lacovia Church. He had probably 80-90% in the starting of Word of Faith in Montego Bay. And we could go on and on. And can you imagine one man so involved in the planting of churches? And I'm just talking just the Deliverance Center churches, because he has started many other churches in the New Testament Church of God. He was also greatly involved. It's hard to just stand here and imagine or to think how fame and fortune can flourish during a lifetime and after the passing of an individual. Fame and fortune that many will flood upon you during your lifetime vanishes. But Delbert Leslie Blair will never be forgotten. Never. As long as I live, and I want to make a word of congratulation to this church or whoever is responsible for the plaque that was unveiled this morning in memory of Delbert and Tessa. Well, Tessa will never go, but in their memory for the work they have done here. But beyond here, I don't know what the family has planned with regards for the perpetual memory of Delbert Blair. But I will ensure that a scholarship fund, if it is not yet established or not in your memory, or a foundation, I'd rather a foundation, I will ensure that the Delbert Blair Foundation be established. And as a matter of fact, I'll go one step further to ensure that it's established. I will ask the trustees of the Deliverance Evangelistic Association to endorse my proposal today in this honorable house to contribute, first of all, $100,000 toward the establishment of the Delbert Blair Foundation. I will ask my wife, the Minister of Finance in my home, to ensure that her husband contributes $100,000 toward the Delbert Blair Foundation. And I just sat there and felt like this ought to be done, because this man's memory shall never leave us, as some people do. Shall never leave us. And I just, thank you, Jesus. I just bless the Lord for all of you. And if my tears will allow me to read my final paragraphs. There were many wonderful aspects to Delbert's life, and many ways that he touched our lives in the Deliverance Evangelistic Association. He will be remembered as a wonderful brother, a great friend, a great pastor, a generous uncle or cousin, an outdoors man, a domino player, a cricket lover, a friendly face in Hopewell and in the areas that he dwell. In all these ways and more, he made our lives richer and fuller. Now that he has gone over a year ago, of course, there is emptiness and pain, confusion, and maybe even anger at death coming to a man of God whom we love so much. But in many ways, the gift of his life is still here with us. He lives on in our memories. He lives on in our stories, and with all of us have become, because of him, he lives. So I encourage you to share today, share tomorrow, and in the years to come, share your memories and your stories of Delbert Blair, and share the pain of your loss as well. In this way, we will keep the gift of Bishop Delbert Blair alive. I thank you.
It is very tempting when you're in a meeting like this to talk, because talking about a church planter, he taught me how to plant church. You don't understand that when I graduated Bethel Bible College, I didn't get a church. They sent me to Spanish Town. And the bishop said, I don't give you a church, you get Spanish Town. You ain't got no church. And I did all this work in Jamaica. They sent me to Boston, Massachusetts. There was no church. They didn't even know about church of God. When we finished serving there, I ended in Palm Bay. And I had to start all over again. And you know what? I called Delbert. And it didn't take him just a matter of days. He was right by my side. The last 35 years, we're pastoring that church. And his memory lives on. The bishop says, let the light shine. So we'll go with that. I think that's the best thing to do right now. Is to go on. Can we call the family, the immediate family of the Blairs, to come and do a combined item? I think that's what we need right at this moment. We need a Blair something. immediately after them, we are going to have that item from the Hopewell.
Praise the Lord. That was a beautiful story, Uncle, our stories. And it's so good to be here walking down memory lane with Uncle. And this is one of the songs that he would sing.
Many years I sighed for rest, perfect peace within my breast, and I often sought the Lord alone in tears. But I could not pay the price, would not make a sacrifice, so I wandered on.
Thank you.
the Lord. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. He has found it. He has found it. I know what it is to sleep in a room over there, because I would fly down here and we'd be here or in Dean's Valley and catch a plane and go back home, because the man had gospel in his guts. We're going to have, at this time, reflections from Hopewell Christian Deliverance Centre, followed by the Voice of Hope. And immediately after the Voice of Hope, we are going to call Sister Simone Taylor from Sandy Bay. And it's going to be in that order. We're trying to catch up with time. We started late.
I say that again. Good morning, everyone. It is indeed a blessing to be in the house of the Lord this morning, celebrating a stalwart. Do you agree with me? Yes. Amen. Bob Marley once said, you know, in this great future, we can't forget our past. But before him, Marcus Garvey said, a people without a knowledge of their past, history, origin, and culture is like a tree without roots. And the Bible, long before Marcus Garvey said, and there arose in Egypt a Pharaoh that know it not Joseph. So this morning we are going down memory lane to share with some of us who have no clue where this came from, because some people, they marvel at the structure, but they know not the foundation. So this morning we are going to bring some light to the situation and hope that at the end of it, you will understand. Reverend Delbert Blair, commissioned by God, began the Christian work in Hopewell in 1981. You heard me right. By erecting a blue and white tent on the orchard playing field for a revival crusade, which was much appreciated, but not without opposition. It was Reverend Bobby Jean Merrick, a missionary from the United States, who donated this tent and was also the one who to make stone to pour this building. I remember the stories fresh when I was a child, that when the first batch of building blocks came here, the church lined up and the building blocks passed through the hands of everyone gathered that day until they were stacked where they were supposed to be. This is coming a far way. Reverend Jack Hates, Reverend Larry Revis, Brother and Sister Smith, Sister Glenda Hill, Oxford, Assemblies of God, Fourth Miles, through the instrumentality of Reverend Robert Crump of New York, Pastor Roger Peterson and his numerous STEM teams, Mrs. Frieda Lindsay of Christ for the Nations, and I see you here, God bless you, Brother Mike Nigren, World Servants, and many more extended their assistance and influence to this mission. Because in this life, if money is all you have, you are very poor. You need your destiny helpers, and you need to call them forth. In March 1985, we saw the establishment of this building. Although it was incomplete, we gathered. We gathered having cement to step over and all of that, but we gathered. And throughout the many years, with God at the helm, this building was completed. It was officially opened and dedicated on August 3, 1987 by Reverend Harold Blair, International President and founder of the Deliverance Evangelistic Association International. The church began to grow as God poured out his Holy Spirit, which is the Spirit of Truth, and numerous things were achieved. These include, but of course not limited to, the establishment of the Hopewell Christian Deliverance Center Early Childhood Institute, which is in the back. It's still going on today. The establishment of the Hope Bible Institute. And guess what? A number of our present ministers today came out of that institute. There was the construction of the Hopewell Training Center. There were missionary trips to Trinidad and Tobago and to Cayman Islands. We worked with the fencing of the church grounds, the paving of the church park, the establishment of a state-of-the-art audio studio, and constructed over 10 indigent houses. And let me tell you this, dealing with the poor was important to Reverend Delbert Blair. He knew what the Bible said, that the Lord stands on the right hand of the poor, and he lived it. One of his outreach was called His Hands Extended. He lived it. We went on to the retiling of the sanctuary. We hosted many local and overseas outreach mission teams. Reverend Delbert Blair, a man with a heart for the people, extended his ministry to other parishes, and this gave birth to the Word of Faith Deliverance Center in Catherine Hall, Montego Bay, the Vision Deliverance Center in La Covia, St. Elizabeth, and the Living Word Deliverance Center in Deans Valley, Westmoreland. Yes, yes. And as our Bishop Harold Blair said, there are many more on the list. The church has grown tremendously over the years, and various departments and groups were given insight, and they were established to see to the work of the vineyard, ladies' fellowship and hospitality groups, health and wellness groups. All the mechanisms needed for outreach were put in place. In 2004, Reverend Delbert Blair received a national honor, Order of Distinction, for his indelible work over the years. And there was an appreciation service held for him in 2009 by the New Testament Church of God USA in Canada, a group responsible for honoring veteran ministers, and the title Veteran Minister was bestowed on him. The building that houses the basic school, the church hall, and the dormitory was named the Delbert Blair Building. The Hopewell Christian Deliverance Center is now accommodating its third pastor in the person of Reverend Roy Green, who himself was a student of the Hope Bible Institute. Reverend Blair was a motivator, a people person, and one who never favored leaving a disagreement to sour interaction. He was that humble that when you had a disagreement with him, he would drive and find you. And when he spoke to you, and I said, "Chuman, come on, man." And he would settle it, and he would move. And because he had a heart for the people and knew how to say, "I'm sorry," we worked alongside the man in the vineyard and carried out God's plan that to this day, those who don't even know him are still benefiting from what was laid. He was a servant leader. And when you have time, research what that means. He will not say to you, "We have that piece of land out there to chop. Chop it." You would see him filing the machete, and he's the first one out there. That was a servant leader. He not only spoke about faith, but he put it into practice. There were times when he would drag ministry. Vanny, Liz, you remember that? He would drag us across this island to some places. Don't ask us those names now. We don't remember. But there were times when dark night would catch us and he would be sleepy around the steering wheel. And we would knock that tambourine and sing all the way to Hopewell to make sure we got here safely. That is the type of person you were dealing with. As with all church establishments, we will encounter struggles. We will encounter spiritual warfare. But to God be the glory. Great things he has done. Great is the faithfulness that God has shown us. And we thank God for giving us this man. And let us not forget, we thank God for giving him the family that worked along with him, that labored with him, so that we could experience God through him. And we bless you. We thank you and have a wonderful day.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah. 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 It will be worth it all. Glory to God. Somebody shout glory in the house right now. It's all right to shout glory. After everything that you have to go through down here, we... Glory to God. We... Glory, 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 glory to God. We shall wear a crown. We still have to remember time and soul, because this thing is getting very tempting right now. But let's have a poem. Let's have a poem. Is this Moon? Would you come and do that poem for us? Immediately after you have done that, the Blair sibling? No, we did that already. You see you? Then we're going to have some saxophone music after her.
Pleasant morning, everyone. Pleasant morning, everyone. My name is Simone Taylor. I'm from the Sandy Bay New Testament Church of God. It's a pleasure to be here this morning to share in this wonderful memorial service. A question came from heaven's portal. Like a happy feather greeted with ink dancing on parchment, are you willing to go on the mission field? A question came from heaven's portal, and Delbert Blair responded, like a happy feather greeted with ink dancing on parchment, are you willing to go on the mission field? His life was all the pen we need. This ink of mine is not enough to capture a dot's worth of the most precious gift that 1939 boasts of. Not just a Blair boy, but a member of the pack of fishers of men whose net was fortified to make him catch a lot. 16 years of life was down on the books when his glorified father added a bonus life, one for food and raiment and the other one for all things instructed by Christ. This pen was all we needed. His life was all the pen we need, and off to work he went in the vineyard, and watching over a dozen and one flock. Through the grace on his life, he gleaned success. The master increased the stock. His pen was all we needed. And off to work he went in the vineyard, watching over a dozen and one flock. And through the grace on his life, he gleaned success, and the master increased the stock. By way of tent revivals, the ink continued to flow. And by God's grace and by God's right hand on him, ministry continued to flourishingly grow. His pen was all we needed. This pen wrote of a balanced life, one which included 5 children and a wife, birthed from a vision they both had, and that familiar question as loaded as a complete meal: are you willing to go on the mission field? As this man made pen dances on paper, I'm stuck with this question. Everything about her life, his life, my life and yours, locked behind your responses, called doors. Everything about her life, his life, my life and yours, is locked behind your responses, called doors. His pen was all we needed. Marriage, ministry, mission, music, philanthropy. These doors swung open by a pen whose point was purpose driven. This pen was all we needed. The lost being reached, the gospel being preached, the nation being impacted. This pen spoke. This pen exemplified, stood the test of time. Now this pen rests. For the time is now when heaven approves with a yes. Marriage, ministry, mission, music, philanthropy. These doors swung open by a pen whose point was purpose driven. The lost being reached, the gospel being preached, the nation being impacted. This pen spoke, this pen exemplified, stood the test of time. Now this pen rests, for the time is now when heaven approves with a yes, with a yes, with a yes. So that question came from heaven's portal, and Delbert Blair responded, and like a happy feather greeted with ink, dancing on parchment, are you willing to go on the mission field? His pen was all we needed. His pen was all we needed. God bless you.
Let's have some music, the saxophone. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. So I was asked to do an item on behalf of the family, and I hope as I do this song that it will really bless your hearts, okay? God benches are in this place, people will get up and start looking apart and walls. We're going to keep it church. Amen? Amen? We're going to keep it church. Now we're going to have a presentation from the IT Friends and Charity Foundation. Let's have that one right now. Put your hands together for this one.
Church. So I'm here to introduce Her Honor, Miss Pamela Blackhall, Parish Court Judge, a daughter of the soil of Hanover, a friend of JT Charity, a very good friend of the Blairs, a family friend since childhood, and most importantly, a child of God. So when the idea came about for the memorial, one of the things I wanted to do we wanted to do was to have a scholarship fund in honor of Daddy, because he loved to help people and people in the community. We didn't know how to do it, so Jennifer, who is a member of the church, she has a program, a scholarship fund that she has that helps young people in the area. So I asked her to, whatever funds collected today, to administer that to help some young person. So Pamela is going to come now and just tell you a little about the organization and also to show a presentation of somebody that they have helped. So that was the idea of having her come. So Pamela and I, we went to high school together. I was ahead of her, of course. But I'm so proud of her because she's now a judge. So give her a hand as she comes. Thank you so much.
Praise the Lord, church. Thank you, Mr. Moderator. Bishop, the Honorable Costas Rotorolum of St. James, Mr. Conrad Pitkin, officiating ministers, other members of the clergy, other distinguished guests, specially invited guests, Bishop Tessa Blair and the family of the Blair, of the person we are honoring today, the very patient, faithful, and formidable congregation here today, a pleasant and wonderful greetings to you all in the wonderful name of Jesus Christ, our Lord. I invite you to look at the program, and I will start with that. Grandchild Callie said, today we gather around to celebrate the long life of my amazing grandpa. So we are here today to celebrate the life of the late Reverend Delbert Blair. And she continued to say that, I know his legacy has inspired many people and will continue to inspire people every day. And of course, one other person who would say that is his daughter, Julene, who said, Daddy, thank you for imparting on me your passion for giving. You not only thought about giving, but you lived it out as a lifestyle. And you can read the rest. So, even though I'm here in the capacity to present for JT and Friends Charity Foundation, I just pause to say, Julene, who has just told you We've been friends for more than 4 decades. But not just me, there's Andrea, and there's Novlek sitting there in the back. And we too became an extension of the Blair's family because of the love and the giving and the sharing. Andrea and I recall that sometimes lunchtime we're told, don't buy any lunch because mommy packed something for you. And that is the love and friendship that we have shared over the years. So it is quite nice to be introduced by a friend of over 4 decades who has become such a close friend. And now I turn to the presentation I'm asked to read by Jennifer, a church sister of you. To everything, there is a season, and you know the rest of Lamentation 3, so there is a purpose in life for everything that happens to us. So the story is told that JT and Friends Charity Foundation, 50 Hearts and More, uniting for a cause. The genesis, from an humble beginning to impressive operations. Reflecting on the milestone of reaching her half century mark, she contemplated what she desired as a gift for this significant milestone gifted to her by God. Guided by her generous spirit, she made the heartfelt decision that in celebrating, she would prefer to give rather than receive. Driven by her love for serving others and a profound desire to witness people prosper and fulfill their dreams and God-intended purpose, Jennifer Taylor Wilson initiated the JT and Friends Charity Foundation on her 50th birthday. This endeavor was both a celebration and a fulfillment of her passion for giving back. As such, JT and Friends Charity Foundation was established on December 4, 2021, commemorating this milestone and celebrating her 50th birthday. In funding the charity 2021, she targeted 50 friends and family members, close association, to use the funds they would normally use to purchase gifts for her to instead translate into each donation to help her raise at least $50,000 to commence this charitable and worthwhile cause. She raised $100,000, thanks to her birthday fans. So over the years, the charity expanded its reach beyond receiving love gifts solely from her birthday fans to forming partnerships with companies and businesses that shared the vision of uniting for a cause, thus empowering our community. Gratitude is extended to these supportive companies: Gateway Cooperative Credit Union Limited, Dernor Printers, Albert Morgan and Company, and AG Accounting and Business Services, among others. Their contribution have played a pivotal role in the growth and success of JT and Friends Charity Foundation. Today, gratitude is extended to the Blair's family for choosing to collaborate with JT and Friends Charity, aligning with the vision of uniting for a cause and empowering our community, particularly our children. the cause. The charity is aimed at providing financial assistance to needy students attending primary and high schools, contributing to school activities that promote the physical and mental health development of students with a special emphasis on sports. Thirdly, our primary focus is in Western Jamaica. The charity has granted scholarships to 3 recipients thus far for the years 2022 and 2023, and contribution to one school's athletics team. Our dedicated board, volunteers, and founder actively engage in maintaining the foundation's operation efficiently. Now, in everything, we must give thanks. And the great, wonderful, and bounteous Father that we serve has given to us, and the opportunities here for us to give back. JT and friends wishes to say thanks firstly to God for this opportunity, which we deem a blessing, to the Blair's family for this gesture and for thinking of JT and Friends Charity, and to the Delbert Blair's Memorial Planning Committee for considering the proposal. We, in addition, say thanks on behalf of the recipients who will benefit from this partnership. Your faithfulness to this charitable venue will not go unnoticed, but your reward will be sure by God. Thank you this year and years to come. I end with this famous quote and our slogan: giving is living, all things die, if only receiving, so give. The late Jeremiah Deany, JP, a member of this church. 50 hearts and more uniting for a cause. So at this moment, we will listen to a thank you from one of the recipients of the wonderful, worthy cause, JT and Friends Charity. Thank you for listening, and please give abundantly. It is for a worthy cause.
Good afternoon, my name is Devontae Boyne. I really do appreciate your assistance. This is a special moment for me, as I will always remember that I can achieve anything I want in life, and that God has sent you as my guardian angel to make my dreams come true. In the future, I want to become a fireman and as well as a chef, because I love cooking. Once again, thank you very much for everything you have done for me.
Thank you, Jennifer. We sincerely appreciate your support. God bless you.
Well, others are going to be able to hear God bless you too, because our friend, Bishop Dr. Delbert Blair, has a grandson in this place. I'd like for him to come out here. He has just waved the rest of you goodbye. Did you see that? Now, he has a daughter that we call, only some of us afford to call her that. The rest of you don't. Call her Vanny. Vanny. I'm going to ask her to come out here. Just Just don't call her. Just ask her to come. Uh-oh. She smiles before she looks. Now you have to come on my other side. Come on my other side. Now smile before we look. You look at me. All right, good. That's all right. That's good. Now we are going to raise, we're going to do some giving. And she called Jesus. Now, oh, you can call Jesus before you smile. Fuck. However, we're going to ask the Lord's blessings on the giving that is going to take place right now. Amen. 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 And amen. Would you stand together with me, everybody? We are celebrating a giver. Gave of his time, his talents, his funds, his energy, his voice, his guitar, and his car, then himself. Let's bow our heads together. Dr. Wigan, would you just pray some of God's blessings on this offering? We're going to give, we're all going to give.
Father, I want to thank you for your goodness. The psalmist said, what shall I render unto the Lord for all his benefits towards me? And we thank you now as we stretch our hands to give, especially to those who are in need, that you would bless each gift and the giver. Supply everyone's need according to your riches in glory by Christ Jesus. We ask you and we thank you now. Amen.
Amen. I do not, I'm not familiar with the way you do it. I was hoping that we'd have some receptacles to. You just start to behave. Come, sister. You're dressed in blue? Come. Well behaved, well behaved. Now, no, wait. Okay, is there one? Give him one. Okay, all right, hold his son. Now, watch them, they're going to go down there. I'm going to ask all the women in here to make sure that he gets more money than her. Have to make sure that she gets more money than him. We're going to do that. Just stand right here. Just smile when they come. Just smile, right? That's all you have to do. Just smile. Okay, I'm going to ask you for this time to sing with me. Everybody. Can you help me this time? Sing the wondrous love of Jesus. Sing his mercies and his grace. In that mansion bright and brother, he prepare us a place. Oh, when we all come on choir, help me stand. Day of rejoicing that will be. Oh, when we all see Jesus, we'll sing and shout the victory. Onward to the prize before us, soon his beauties will behold.
to their pearly gates we'll open. We shall tread the streets of gold. Oh, when we are yet to hear. Oh, what a day of rejoicing that will be when we all see Jesus. Oh, sing and shout the victory. Yes. Oh, when we all get to him. Yeah, what a day of rejoicing that will be when we all, hallelujah, oh, we sing and shout the victory. Let us then be true and faithful, trusting, serving every day. Just one glimpse of him in glory will the toils of life repay. Yeah, when we all get to heaven. Oh, what a day of rejoicing that will be. Yeah, when we all see Jesus, we'll sing and shout the victory. Oh, when we all get to heaven.
What a day.
Hallelujah. When we all see Jesus, we'll sing and shout the victory. Oh, when we all get to heaven, what a day of rejoicing that will be. Oh, when we all praise him, we will sing one more time, everybody. Yeah, when we all get to heaven, what a day
of rejoicing and jubilee.
Oh, when we all see Jesus, we'll sing and shout the victory. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Thank you. Thank you. We're not counting it any money in this church. Jesus use whips when you do trading inside here. Just we're not counting. You're both winners. Amen. All right. We are going to have photo remembrance at this time. Don't know who's responsible. Photo remembrance. Okay, just sit down, right? Uh-huh.
Myself and find it, Lord, in the
myself and find it, Lord, in thee. Let me lose myself and find it, Lord, in thee. May all self be slain, my friend, see only thee. Though it cost me grief and pain, I will find my life again if I live. I was drifting alone in darkness, heart filled with sin and brokenhearted. I got so troubled about my worries, not knowing that Jesus cared for me. Then one day, while bowed in prayer, I prayed to him about the matter. Oh, hallelujah, glory, hallelujah. I've got my burdens rolled away. Oh, hallelujah, glory, hallelujah. I've got my burdens. I'm so happy now to tell it what the good Lord's done for me. I praise his name while ages roll, and from his side I'll never roam. Oh, hallelujah, glory, hallelujah. I've got my burden. Now in Jesus, since from sin, I've been set free. He took away my heavy burden, set my captive spirit free. I'll praise his name, where here I go, I want this old world to know. Oh, hallelujah, glory, hallelujah. Got my burdens rolled away. Oh, hallelujah, glory, hallelujah. I've got my burdens rolled away.
Well, it's about time somebody shout in this place. Thing that God has given us grace so that we are not crying today, we are rejoicing. That is one man that cannot go back again. He's safe in the arms of Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. While we're settling, we're going to have reflections from the immediate family. And please get ready because we're going to have the speaker shortly. A representative from the immediate family will be. Okay. And she's smiling too. Look at that. Praise God, praise God. You know, the eros, now you have to tell you this one, the eros are not all. Late Sir Alexander Bustamante said, the eros are not all 6 feet tall.
Okay, good morning, everyone. Good afternoon. We are here to celebrate the life of Daddy. I would always talk about him as this. What a man Delbert Blair was. I promise myself I'm not gonna cry, but when I look at the choir, basically, choir members that was here when Daddy was here. And the same type of energy that was given this morning, that's what Daddy would allow us to do. Nothing less. And as we reflect this morning, we just want to give God thanks for the life, for the legacy that he left us, for, everything that he has done. We can give God thanks for what he has done. A man of purpose, a man of passion, a man of just a man, a real man. What a man Delbert Blair was. No fake. If he says he's going to do something, he's going to do it. If he says he's going to give you something, he's going to give it. No fake. The man was a man of his word, noble character. And as I look around, the musicians here are some that have been here ever since. And I just want to give God thanks for my father's legacy, our father's legacy, this church, our legacy. And I want to give God thanks as we try to sing the song. One thing, before Mark starts, I remember the first time we ever sang in church. Roxy and Mark, they were, setting up the instrument, and Vanny and I were cleaning. Because we had to clean the church, not because we were pastor's kids. And we started singing. Sunday morning, we totally forgot about everything. Sunday morning, Daddy went up. Well, I heard two young ladies singing yesterday. Liz and Vanny come up here and sing the song. And I was like, really? But, it helped us.
grow, even though we're still shy. And I want to give God thanks for Delbert Willesley.
I am not a speaker, but I just want to say that to God be the glory, great things he has done. Notice that there's just four of us here. Roxy was unable to make it, and in his absence, you know, I hope he's watching. Roxy, we love you, we miss you, and I know you love Dad, and we all do.
All right, well, since they all spoke, I won't say not much. Let's get to it. But I just want to say I'm thankful to God for Dad's legacy, but also just for the opportunity of seeing Colette, Dave, Carl, Dwight to play with his musicians that probably, about over 30 years ago, they were all here playing, and it's so good to be back, band reunited, you know, all of that, and that's all because of that. So, Art.
How can I say thanks for the things you have done for me, things so undeserved, yet you gave to prove your love for me, the voices of a million. Endeavor, hope to be.
That's not quite how we practiced it, but it went off. Thank you.
If it was a rally, we'd have to call encore. Pastor Stone Barrett will introduce the speaker of the day, and she will come at this time. Pastor Stoneberg.
Praise God. Good afternoon, brothers and sisters, bishops and pastors and ministers. You know, I am here to introduce the guest speaker, and we are far gone over time, but I just sat there and I was just thinking what a great legacy the Blairs have really left behind. I'm talking about Daddy Blair and Mama Blair. I'm talking about Delbert and all the Blairs that have gone on ahead. And as I sat there and I thought about it, I said, ladies and gentlemen, brothers and sisters, from Hopewell, from Living Word, from Vision, from Word of Faith, don't allow Bishop Blair's legacy to die. Don't allow his legacy to die. I pray to God that whatever, if there's any situation, I am sure that it can be worked out. Don't allow his legacy to die. Amen, amen. It is my privilege to introduce to you this afternoon Bishop, the Honorable Conrad H. Pitkin. Bishop, the Honorable Conrad H. Pitkin was born in Morant Bay, St. Thomas, Jamaica. He attended the Rural Hill Primary School in Portland, that is where Bishop Bernard is from, and was privately tutored thereafter. studying the disciplines to include social psychology, supervisor management, human relationships, evangelism, and humanitarian law. He's a graduate of the Assembles of God Institute of Theology, now Assembles of God Bible College, with an associate degree in theology. Bishop Pitkin also obtained a bachelor's degree in theology from Caribbean School of Theology, CST, and a master's degree, summa cum laude, in ministerial studies from Global University, Springfield, Missouri, USA. He's a member of the International Honor Society, Delta Epsilon Tau, Global University, Missouri, Chapter, USA. Bishop Pitkin has served the Assemblies of God in various capacities, locally and internationally. He was chairman of the Caribbean Executive of Assemblies of God Fellowship, member of the World Fellowship of the Assemblies of God Executive, and a lot more. Presently, Bishop Pitkin serves as a senior pastor of the Faith Temple Assemblies of God, 6 Princess Street, Montego Bay. He is a dynamic conference speaker who is considered a visionary leader and nation builder, who is involved in numerous national and community activities. Some of these activities include being Custos Rotulorum for the Parish of St. James, immediate past president of the Jamaica Association of Full Gospel Churches, chairman of the Western Board for the Errol Rattray Evangelism Association, and the list goes on. Under his leadership of senior pastor of the Faith Temple Assembly of God, Bishop Pitkin has developed several outreach initiatives and programs, including health fair, the Pastor's Back to School Support Fund, a street feeding program in collaboration with CUMI, food basket for the indigent, builds and renovate homes for the indigent, a community transformation outreach program. Bishop the Honorable Conrad A. Pitkin is married to Beverly, here ladies, married to Beverly for 49 years, and with their union producing 5 children and 11 grandchildren. One of Bishop Pitkin's unwavering belief is that a country's most important resource is its people, with their creative and positive energy, and that as Jamaicans, we must be committed to a life of excellence in the performance of our duties in service to God, the Creator, and our country. Right after the choir ministers in song, the next voice you'll hear will be that of Bishop Pitkin. And I'll ask you to stand and make him welcome soon after. God bless you.
Hallelujah. Just lift your hands and worship the Lord, somebody. Just lift your hands and worship the Lord, somebody.
Hallelujah.
We're here to worship God. We're here to worship God.
Hallelujah.
We're here to honor the man that found me when I was a nobody, when I couldn't change my shoes, when I couldn't change my pants, I couldn't change my shirt. God sent him to Hopewell and he found me. And I'm here today to lift up the name of Jesus as we honor him. Hallelujah. Can you give yourself, just give yourself a round of applause for being here. Just wave your hands for victory, somebody. Woo! Yeah. Country where no twilight shadows deepen, an ending day where night shall never be. A city where no storm clouds ever gather. Oh, this is just what heaven means to me. What will it be when we to join the throne upon the glassy sea? The golden green our loved ones and crown Christ forever. This is just what heaven means to me. The place where I'll be known is understanding. Before all the meteors rot or the unkind words to bruise the heart you've spoken. Oh, this is just whatever needs to be. What will it be when we get over yonder to join the throne upon the glassy sea? We're gonna greet our loved ones and crown Christ forever. Because he died on Calvary for me. And when they crown him Lord of all forever, oh, this is just whatever it means to me.
What will it be when we get over yonder to join the throng upon the glassy sea? Gonna greet our loved ones and crown Christ forever. Oh, this is just what heaven means to me.
Help us sing a choir.
What will it be when we get over yonder to join the throng upon the glassy sea? We're gonna greet our loved ones and crown Christ forever. Oh, this is just what heaven means.
Sing it with us, Father. Oh,
what will it be when we get over yonder to join the throng upon the glassy sea? We're gonna greet our loved ones and crown Christ forever. Oh, this is just what heaven means to me. What will it be when we get over yonder to join the throng upon the glassy sea?
We're gonna greet our
loved, we're gonna greet our loved ones and crown Christ forever. This is just what heaven means to me.
What will it be?
What will it be when we
upon legacy sea.
We're gonna greet our loved ones and from Christ forever.
This is just what heaven means to me.
This is just what heaven means to me.
This is just what heaven means to me.
This is just what heaven means.
This is just what heaven means to me.
This is just what heaven means.
This is just what heaven means to me.
This is just.
This is just what heaven means to me.
Shall we bless the Lord? Want to lift your hands and just wave in the presence of the Lord? Give him thanks. Almighty God and our Father, to you be the honor, the glory, and the praise. We magnify you today for your goodness, for your mercies. Thank you for the life and service of our dear beloved brother who has gone before us and is now in glory. Thank you for bringing us together today to celebrate a life well lived. Now bless your word to our hearts and magnify your name. And may the words of my mouth and the meditation of our hearts be acceptable in your sight, O Lord, our God, and our Redeemer. And the people of God say, Amen. Thank you. God bless you. You may be seated. Thank you, Bishop Moderator Lewinson. To the immediate family of our late Bishop Delbert, led by Bishop Tessa, Bishop the Honorable Dr. Era Blair and Dr. Alma Blair, Bishop W.A., and after that it's easy to say, and all the Blair's family, so I don't get myself in trouble. But I should say to Ainsley, I'm not seeing him anymore, but it's good to see him. It's a long time that I have not seen Ainsley. To Reverend Robert Williams, representing Bishop Noticed. Reverend Dr. Peter Burnett, immediate past president of the St. James Ministers, all the members of the clergy on the platform and in the audience, a pleasant good afternoon. Good afternoon. So we have come today to celebrate. This is the second leg of the celebration. And I'm very humbled by the privilege and the opportunity to speak today. When I saw the invitation, I asked the Secretary of the Office, look again. And she said, yes, you're not only invited, you are to speak. Since the person who introduced me said that we are over time, I am conscious of the time. But this year, would have been 36 years since I would have met my friend in a very unusual way. Of course, young man growing up, I knew about the Blairs. Another matter, I won't even talk today. People hear me speaking somewhere, they will say I sound like a certain Blair. And they said, are you one of the Blair's brother? I said, but my name is Pitkin. But it was during Gilbert in 1988. Family and I took up the pastorate at Faith Temple on the 1st of September, 1988. Gilbert passed through on the 12th. And at that time, being very, very, very green to St. James, your mettle is going to be tested now if you're really the person to pastor this church. Food was scarce. You had to join line to get some food for your people. And there was this group that was formed by, I think, this gentleman over here, my friend and brother, Project Accord. The person who was, no, Delbert was not yet the chairman. It was Reverend Green was the chairman of the fraternity when I came, the Baptist minister. Delbert became, just immediately after Reverend Green was going on, but Reverend Green was the local chairman of Project Accord. So you have to go to Reverend Green. I didn't know Reverend Green. When I went to the spot, it was Bishop Delbert who introduced himself to me and told me who he was and wanted to know who am I, and I shared with him. And he said, don't worry, I will take care of you. You stay right there. And that's how the relationship started. And it blossomed not just into pastor knowing pastor, but it blossomed into a brother friend. I just said to Bishop Herrera that when this party was being built, I was around. I used to come down here in the days and sit down with him as we shared together. I used to preach, and when I finished preaching, I go down the road and climb the hill to get Sister Tessa's cooking that on a Sunday evening. And she can cook, trust me. And so sometimes, even outside a Sunday, I would drive by, go down there, so I can get lunch or whatever was going on. We shared, brothers and sisters. We were close. And I thank God that my life has been better for having known one Delbert Willesley Blair. And I rejoice with the family today. In fact, I can't tell everything, it's going to be too long. But it's through him that I knew Dean's Valley too. And I had to go to Dean's Valley for crusades and for preaching engagement and for seminars. I had to drive all the way from Montgomery to Dean's Valley because he wants me to be there if I'm going to be speaking during the day at some conference, some seminars. But I met Bishop Bernard through him. Also, we are part of the Montgomery Church because of him. At that time, it was one Reverend Whitaker that was at the Montgomery Church. And Bishop Blair member of the family, I joined with you. And sir, and members of the family, I pledge $50,000 as a part of the foundation. And I know, I have no doubt, that the Blair's family and this church will ensure that the legacy of our friend and brother will go on and will never die. Amen. But life is a journey, an interesting one too. I tell people that between birth and death, there are many curves, many corners that you have to negotiate. And how you negotiate them determines how successful you are in your Christian journey or in your journey of ministry. As I said that, I remember another friend of mine, his name is Fedlin Deason. He said, you keep your corner and I keep mine, there'll be no collision. But we are pilgrims and sojourners, brothers and sisters, on this road that leads to the holy city, a city not built with human hands, a city where there will be no crying, no sadness, no memorials, no funerals. But today we are gathered to honor and remember the life of a friend, a colleague, a brother, husband, father, grandfather, pastor, and a pioneer extraordinaire in the person of Bishop Delbert Blair. I remembered we talked about Riverton City. I don't know, Bishop Blair, what's going on in Riverton City. But his desire, his passion, was to establish a church over in Riverton City. And he wanted to do that as he worked alongside the Food for the Poor. And in St. James and in Western Jamaica, he was the one that was responsible for the expansion of the Food for the Poor ministry in these areas. He ensured, and when he became chairman of the fraternal, after Reverend Green, he delved himself into that section of community service and ensured that persons like me became a part of it. There was only one disagreement that Brother Delbert and myself had. He wanted me to be chairman of the St. James Ministers Fraternal. I told him no. That's the only fight we had. But guess who prevailed? He did. Because he said, I'm not going to have it any other way, although I tried to convince him that I was the last pastor to have come into St. James. The person there is much more senior me that should take up that position. And you know how challenging it can be, right? And he said, no. You are going to be the chairman and I am going to stand by you. And you are going to be success. I said, okay, sir, I give up. And so I became the chairman after I succeeded him. He was one of Jamaica's popular and prolific pastor and preachers. This man lived a miraculous life, an extraordinary life. You have heard the reflections. He was an admirable individual, deeply loved pastor and Christian leader. Somebody say he was a servant leader, which means that he was a servant who leads and a leader who served. And there was no task that he could not carry out himself. So if he asks you to do something, it is something that he himself could do and will do alongside of you. That's the person we have come to celebrate today. He was a man of dignity. He was not as tall as one Hero Blair, but he had pride, and he walked with that statue, and he had a presence that when he walked into a room, you know that Delbert was in the room. That was the person. He displayed a very calm spirit, though. I can't ever see him upset. He was always a broad smile that was close to a laugh. He was a resolute person, conscientious, and he was committed to his God, committed to his family. He was a deep family man. When he spoke of his children, his eyes would lit up at a bright small smile across his face. And again, I'm not going to get myself in no trouble, but there are some names that he loved to call. I'm not going to get myself in no trouble. You understand, Bishop? Brothers and sisters, Bishop Delbert's life touched many. Not just touched, but overwhelming them with love and kindness. He knew what it meant to be compassionate. He knew what it meant to exercise the kindness of God. But there will come a day when the journey will be over and we will be safely at home in the Father's house. We will be in a place of peace, a place of safety, and a place of perfection. And can I say, brothers and sisters, that Bishop Delbert is just one step ahead of us. And we ought to be conscious that we too, if the Lord tarries, will make the same exit. And if we are faithful to God, we will be in the same place. And so we should look forward for the day when the trump of God will sound. And this world shall be no more. And the voice of the archangel and the shout of the Lord, when we will be gathered together. We will meet our brother. You will meet your husband. You'll meet your father, grandfather again. And there to reunite and to rejoice together in the Lord. So while you and I traveled this troubled world, let us continue, because I want to say to you today that trouble might trouble you here. Sickness might trouble you here. The heartaches of this life will trouble you here, but they can't follow you home. Can I get a witness from somebody? They will not follow you home, because life will be different in the presence of the Lord. And some of us sitting here, and those who have joined us virtually, that some of us may be defeated. Some of us may get discouraged. Some of us may even be disillusioned. But I want you to know that what you are going through will end one of these days. Hallelujah. And you will be home with your Father, your God, at last. The Bible tells us that it will be better then when we shall see our Lord. So today, I want to share with you briefly from the 21st chapter of Revelation and the first 7 verses. And every preacher knows it very well, so I don't have to read it. And all faithful Christians ought to know it. So I want to take the passage, and I want to show you some of life bullies that will not follow you home. What is it? Some of life's bullies that will not follow you home. You know, somehow I become very close to the Blair's family. Very, very close. And as I see Sister Evan, I just thought of her beloved husband. Yes. He was also one of those persons who mentored me in the years that I met him. And I assume responsibility in the Full Gospel Association that he was responsible for. And I still have those responsibility. So let's look at the Word of God. Revelation chapter 21. The first thing that cannot follow you is sorrow. You will have sorrow here, but sorrow cannot follow you home. Tell your neighbor, sorrow won't follow you home. So there is no denying that this life is a life of trouble. It's a life of heartaches. It's a life of sorrow of different kinds. Trials and tragedies. Every day we hear accounts of diseases, distresses, discouragements, and death. Last night I was in St. Thomas and Portland with my family. In fact, they're still there. I'm the only one on this side because my son is here and his family. And so we decided to spend the time together. But my daughter said to me, Daddy, I need to find a pastor. His sister just died in the United States. Young woman. My wife was counseling at one time. And she had many troubles and many challenges in her life. And she said, Daddy, I just got the news. The only way that I can find her is to find her brother. And I think I found him. Because he's an Assemblies of God pastor. And she could not remember the name. But when no sooner I came home, the news came out that young pastor, her sister died in New York. But we hear of death and it shakes us hard. Especially when those persons are close to us. And brothers and sisters, the only reconciliation or consolation that a Christian has in this life is that when you know that your loved one knows the Lord, walked with Christ, served Christ, and did his or her best in the kingdom of God, there is hope to meet again. That's all that we have. And people are shocked when we rejoice and sing the songs of glory, knowing that this is not the end for a child of God. And there isn't one of us in this room who has come this far in the journey unscathed by the troubles of life. Not one of us. In fact, many, if not all of us, bear the scars of our journey in our hearts and in our mind, and sometimes in our bodies. We bear the scars, and the scars reminds us of the journey. But I'm always reminded of the psalm that says, yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for thou art with me. Your rod and your staff, they comfort me on that journey. And brothers and sisters, only God can comfort us in these times
Many things in our lives have not gone as it planned. I don't know if any of you are like me and can identify with this. Some things are not gone like we planned. No. We want them to be a certain way. But we know what sorrow is all about. It is the lot of every human being who can ever live or will ever live on this earth. So according to verse 4 of the text, the troubles and trials of life cannot follow us home. They stop here. Aren't you glad, brothers and sisters? So when we leave this world, whether it will be by the rapture or the graveyard, there is just some things that cannot go with us. Things that we need to think about, that in heaven there will be no more. And the first one I wanted to is death. In heaven, there will be no dying. There will be no graves that will be dug. There will be no undertakers. And these days I find myself, Bishop, after be calling the undertakers to ask for discounts for loved ones who have passed, because it is so expensive to bury a dead. But thank God that the day is coming when the undertakers will be out of business. Hallelujah. Because there will be no dying. Death cannot follow us. And I told you that sorrow cannot follow us. It refers to grief of any kind. It speaks to all the pain, the trouble, the heartaches that we will experience in this life. The disappointments, the trials, the problems, the loss of a friend, the loss of property, the loss of a loved one, death of a loved one, persecution, and our own failures are all in view here in the text. But truly, brothers and sisters, this life is a life of heartache. This life is a life of sorrow. But not one of these things that trouble you and trouble me will follow us there. Not one. There'll be no crying in heaven. Crying is the idea of an outburst or an outcry. It refers to those times when we are absolutely overwhelmed and broken by the events of life. I was 7 years old when my grandfather died, and I never forget. The school was just down the road from me, from the home. And the message came that my grandfather was dying, and the teacher should release me from school so I could see my grandfather before he died. And they came, and they didn't say that. I was told, they just said, you need to get home as fast as you can. And I ran out of the classroom and hopped the hill in Rural Hill. And when I got to the step, my grandmother shouted, he is gone. I can't forget it. It resides in me. It is bedded in me as a young boy, because they said that my grandfather was asking for me. I was the first great-grandchild. And they took me as a son in the home. So I grew up as the last child of my grandfather and my grandmother. And so it was painful to hear the shout, the outcry of a grandmother who shouted, "He is gone." But in that home, there will be no more shout. If there's a shout, it's a shout from the elders. And from the ten thousand saints of God that will be around the throne of God, giving homage and paying praise to our God and the Lamb who bought us with his blood. So there'll be no more pain, no more crying. Friends, that will never happen in glory. Life may trouble you here, but it cannot follow you home. Then there's no more pain. The pain we suffered. Pain means to labor, to toil, or it means great trouble. And I'm just sharing some thoughts with you. Because my mom also died from multiple myeloma, one of the most painful sickness that you can ever find. If you walk by the bedside, you don't touch it, the person feels it. I remember my mom used to stretch her hand like this. And every time we journeyed to University of the West in this clinic, the doctor would say, "Are you ready for the medication? You're feeling pain?" And she said, "No." She said, "Morphine is for the dead. I don't want it." But the last Friday we went to the University of the West Indies, my mom looked at the doctor and said, "I will take it now." And I looked at her and said, "Mom, you mean all the time you're stretching and squeezing your hand, you're feeling pain?" She said, "My son, there's nothing you can do. So I tell you." When I asked her, she just smiled. That was a Friday. She took one dose the Saturday. And Sunday morning, she said, "I am not feeling no pain. I don't want anymore." Now, you know, morphine is expensive, right? Somehow, by Sunday morning, God cushioned the pain of my mother. On the Wednesday night, she went to glory. The Lord took her out of her pain. The disease, the disappointment, the distress that we encounter as we move through this world, we feel, because this body is not immune from disease, is not immune from sickness. But when you know, not when somebody tells you, when you know that this is just for a season and it will all pass and God will receive you into his home in glory, where the streets are lined with gold and the walls are lined with jasper, and there is no cottage anywhere there, but a mansion, a harp and a crown for the beloved child of God who has been victorious in the Christian walk, the pain and the distress down here will be worth it all. Oh, can I get a witness from somebody in here? The good news, brothers and sisters, is that none of these will follow us home. No hospitals, no broken homes, no broken hearts, no trials, no tribulation will be able to go to glory with us. It will all end here as we go home to be with the Lord. The final one is tears. There is tears of joy, but there's another kind of tears. And I tell some, I say sometimes in church, that the pillow that we sleep on could talk. And if those pillow would not absorb the tears and dry by morning, it will tell the tales of the heartache we feel. Although we come to church on the Lord's Day morning with a broad smile in our face, as if nothing is going on, if the pillow could tell the tale of the tears we shed. But this is the sum of the blessed promise that we have for heaven. All the things that drives us weeping, all the things that drives us soaring down here will not follow us over there. Hallelujah. Sorrow follows us today, but I want to tell you, brothers and sisters, sorrow and trouble, heartaches and trials and disappointment will trouble us down here, but they can't follow us to heaven. Jesus said, let not your heart be troubled. He believed in God, believed also in me. In my Father's house are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you. I go to prepare a place for you. And if I go, I will come again and receive you unto myself, that where I am, there you may be also. There's a story about a Reverend Samuel Morrison, a missionary, faithful missionary, who served in Africa for 25 years. But because of failing health, Morrison returned home. On the same voyage that he came home traveling on, in the ocean liner, was President Teddy Roosevelt, who had been in Africa for 3 weeks on a hunting expedition. As the large ship pulled inside of the New York Harbor, it looked as though the entire city of New York had come home to welcome President Roosevelt. Music filled the air. Banner waffled in the wind. Balloons flew in the sky. Flash bulbs were popping and confetti streamed down like snow. As Roosevelt stepped into sight, the crowd exploded into applause and cheers. It was truly a reception fitting a king. While all the eyes were on the president, Morrison quietly disembarked and slipped through the crowd. None of the applause was for him, and nobody was there to welcome him home. His heart began to ache as he prayed, Lord, the president has been in Africa for 3 weeks killing animals, and the whole world turned out to welcome him home. I have given 25 years in Africa serving you, and no one has greeted me or even know that I am here. The story goes, he felt a gentle touch of God and sensed the Spirit says, but my dear child, you are not home yet. Hallelujah. Not home yet, for this is not our home. This is not our dwelling place. We are mere pilgrims and travelers down here. We are on a journey, brothers and sisters. We are going home. And one day, it'll be home at last. Home at last. In our Savior's bosom. What a joyous thought to realize that presidential reception pale in comparison to the heavenly homecoming that awaits a child of God. Hallelujah. Song said, if heaven is not my home, then Lord, what will I do? The angels beckoned me from heaven's open door. And oh, I can't feel at home in this world anymore. Oh, hallelujah. Some of us can say, I have a loving mother just over in glory land. And I don't expect to stop until I shake her hand. She's waiting now for me at heaven's open door. And I can't feel at home in this world anymore. Sister Tessa, you can say, I have a loving husband. Children, I have a loving father. And I can join with the Blair's brother. I have a loving brother just over in glory land. And I don't expect to stop until I shake his hand. He's waiting now for me at heaven's open door. And I can't, oh hallelujah, and I can't feel at home in this troubled world of trials anymore. Hallelujah. The homecoming awaits the child of God. So my friend, you may be troubled by many things, but if you continue to serve God, don't worry. We are not home yet. Touch your neighbor and say, we are not home yet. So if you don't get your homecoming welcome, don't feel anyway. We are not home yet. But one great day, hallelujah, angels will await to welcome us home. And I can't sing like Harold Blair. I can't sing like Ainsley Blair. Not W.A. Blair, nor my late friend and brother Delbert. No. But I tell them like I tell other singing preachers. When we get to heaven, they will not outsing me. I will join them in the choir. And I will sing with them the songs of the redeemed. And angels will fold their wings and listen to the great choir of earth sing the songs of the redeemed. For angel never knew the joy that true salvation bring. Redeem how I love to proclaim it. Redeemed by the blood of the Lamb. Redeemed through his infinite mercy. His child. And forever I am. Can somebody shout a hallelujah? Every step I take is a step that is closer home. Can I talk to somebody here? Hey, every message I preach is a message that brings me closer home. We are on our way to glory. You may get there before I do, or I may get there before you do, but we will all meet on that getting up morning. Somebody shout with me a hallelujah. Hallelujah. You may need to have a talk with Jesus today. You may be struggling today. But I want to close in saying, hallelujah. Fix your thought on Jesus. Surrender your life to him. Because joy is coming. Weeping may endure for a night, but joy comes in the morning. God bless you.
Glory to God. It will be worth it all when we see Jesus. All trials will seem so small when we see Christ. One glimpse of His dear face, all sorrow will erase. So bravely run the race till we see Christ. It will be worth it all when we see Jesus. Our trials will seem so small when we see Christ. One glimpse of His dear face, all sorrow will erase. So bravely run the race till we see Christ. Hallelujah. There is nothing that you and I can add to that word. Why don't we ask Bishop Tessa Blair, some usher, take her gently up here for me. Okay, let me meet you then and escort you. Praise God. Praise God.
Glory!
Hallelujah. My.
Okay, you may wonder what's going on. These are my two bears. And there is always a conflict because this one, at one time he thought that he was the only grandchild. And then this one came, Cully and Adrian. Cully came, and so Adrian, he took it to heart and to say, well, I have lost my position. But thank God, I'm happy for them. And his father could not be here, her father, because of illness. So I'm happy to have you, son. I know your time is almost gone, and I'm just here to say thanks. But I have to think about the message. Were you blessed? Yeah. It's only a pity we didn't have more time to absorb and to enjoy the, but it's a powerful message. So I'm just going to go right ahead to say thanks to our Honorable Conrad Pickton, CDJP, for being with us today and for challenging us as he speaks to us about heaven and how many of us are anticipating going to heaven. Heaven is a real place. Hell is a real place, and there's no middle place, no middle ground. So it's either one place or the other. So it's either we are going to be with Jesus or we are going to be with the devil into everlasting fire. We don't want to go there. So that's why we give our hearts and our lives to Jesus. Amen. He has said so many things, and I trust that you have gathered whatever was said by our speaker. I'd like to say, I'm just here to say thank you to Bishop Harold Blair and his wife, Dr. Alma Blair, for coming. Reverend Kenute Reagan, would you just wave your hand, sir, if you want to stand? Who Pastor Maureen Stone Barrett. Would you stand? Yes, these two persons were the head leaders in promoting this program that we're having here. Reverend Reagan and his wife, they live in Canada, but they are our adopted son and daughters, and so they are part living in Jamaica and part in Canada. They are blessed. So we are very happy to have you. And Sister Pastor Maureen Stone Barrett is pastor in the church in Dean's Valley, and she's doing a tremendous work. For the other persons who are involved in us being here today, I'd just like to say thanks to you. Think of Pastor Green and the congregation members, the choir. Didn't they sing beautifully today? Were you blessed by the songs that they had? You see, and so we are so very happy that they have been here. Other ministers who are here, we thank you for coming. It could be a different picture, but thanks for coming. Our good friend here that we have not seen for quite a while, we thank you, sir, for being here. And although I don't know if any other ministers are down in the congregation, but I'm just saying to you all, members, friends, thanks for being here today to allow us to talk a little bit about Delbert Blair. I have one story that I'd like you to hear. When he started building this place, there was an elderly gentleman who sat at the roadside every day. And then one day he stopped and asked, "Who is this man?" It was discovered that this man was a retired policeman who didn't have a home. He was just there out in the cold. And what Delbert Blair did, he called his church together. Hallelujah. And he got some men, and he got some material from Food for the Poor. He worked with Food for the Poor for a long time. So he got material, and he built a house, a little corner of the church property. It is still there today, and took our brother from off the street. I say to God be the glory. I had forgotten to mention my Bible school student friend in the person of Dr. Willesley Blair. And at that time, I didn't know that he would be a brother-in-law. But we used to have some real fight in Bible school. We can't go there, so today. But God has a way of doing things. Sister Bishop Dr. Blair, she was also a member. We were all through, and Ronald's wife, we were all members together in Bible school. We didn't know that God had something big for us. So we are very happy. Then I am happy to have my sister Pansy. Would you stand, Pansy? And my brother Cless, and my nieces and nephews. Where are you? All the nieces, stand. Only two. There are about 5-6 of them over the house, and they have been helping me ever since they came. And all the friends, all our friends. And you know what I like about God? Okay, I'm so sorry. Reverend Williams from the Lucy Church, he represented the... Is he Syria? Oh, I'm so sorry. Ah, Lord, you know, it is hard to say things in a short time. You tend to forget. But we are very happy for the musicians and everybody who have come to make today the blessed day. And we say to God with the glory, great things he has done. And of course, our children. Mark was on the keyboard, Jelaine, Devaney, Lydia. Roxy, as we said, was not able to be here, but thank God for those who have been here. And of course, I introduce my granddaughter and my grandson. So I'm so saying again, God bless you for coming, for being the person that you have been made to be. One more thing. Let me see the hand of all the members of the church who were converted under Delbert's ministry. You're here. Just stand. They are still here, and there, I tell you what, there are some who have strayed, but we are going to pray them back. We are going to pray them back. And of course, I forgot my stepdaughter, my adopted daughter, Big Vanny. So we have Big Vanny and we have Little Vanny. And Elvie, who has sometime been in our lives. Thanks for coming. Brother Clinton and his wife. Oh my goodness, it's too much. But thank God that we are here, and thank you all again for coming to make today a blessed day. There is refreshment at the back of the church. A building is over there. I don't know what they have to offer you, but if you are hungry, just go around there and you will be fed. Amen. God bless you.
Well, let me say thanks again to everyone. I'd like to, in a very special way, you know, I've been pastoring for a while now. I didn't start yesterday. I started in 1956. So it doesn't make me a rookie anymore. I'm still pastoring. But I want to bless this man, Pastor Green, who has taken the baton and is taking the ministry the second step. When you run a relay, the man who grabs the baton from the first person is a very delicate position to take. Because, yes, the other person started, and we have all of this. But, you know, it takes an experienced, strong, well-thinking, consecrated person to lead it to the end. Amen. So, since there can't be any break in between, Pastor Lewinson is saying, we don't have a Pastor Blair's church and Pastor Green's church. Pardon the pastor right now. Just give me a break. Right, sir? It's one ministry. I say I'm pastoring a long time. Amen? It's one church. And I'm appealing to the old church and the new church, because as a person that, you see these men down here dressed up in black, they have a way of transferring us from place to place. And when you get a transfer, for a little while you're pastoring two churches. You're pastoring part of the old church from the pastor before, and a church that you are now helping to get in shape. Amen? And so I want to appeal to the older brethren to remember this young man. Amen? And pray for him. He is not Delbert. He wasn't a Blair. And he won't, Don't even smile at me, man. You won't be a Blair. This man is green. And he's green. The whole church has to stand behind him now and said, we are not going to let the dream die. We're not going to let the vision die. I am an old man. Long time I was 80. But I'm still going on. And this is not too far. We will come and back you up. For we don't want this vision to die. Amen. Moses took the children of Israel out of Egypt. He took a Joshua to take them in. Amen. 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 Is the church still with me? I know that you're saying, where him come from? But I am appealing to the whole church, the whole city, that we come together and keep this thing going. Amen. And I do believe that God is in this thing and it will go on. It will go on. I had in mind, I was going to make a little boost stuff because the offering was a little on the lower side. But then we got a little offering afterwards. We collected 73,350. No. You got to help me with this Jamaican money. I born here. 73,350. And I don't know how much it will take to make it 100,000. But, pardon? 27? This is not a rally, but I don't believe we want to let it go down like that. Amen? Amen? I'm church, a bond church of God, so I'm accustomed to hearing it. Don't scare me. All right, everybody, no, just go for it and bring it. Onward to the prize before us, soon as beauties will be. All soon the pearly gates will open. We will tread the streets of gold. Oh, when we all get to heaven, what a day of rejoicing that will be. When we all get to heaven, what a day of rejoice. We will sing and shout. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Time is very precious. I don't know how to translate this, but we are having some more here. Okay, if you're going, please do it quickly for me. I'm accustomed to that. I'm short. See that? Get to me.
rejoicing that will be when we all see Jesus. We will sing and shout the victory. Oh, when we all get to heaven, what a day of rejoicing that will be when we all see Jesus. We will sing and shout the victory. Oh, when we all get to heaven, what a day of rejoicing that will be when we all see Jesus. We will sing and shout the victory.
Would you stand together with me, with somebody who is responsible for the finances, take care of this for us. Our Father, we give you glory and honor and praise today. We thank you for this service. We thank you for this family. We thank you for this church. We pray a special blessing upon the man who is now in charge. Let there be a double portion of your anointing, your wisdom, hallelujah, and your power upon him. Open the eyes of the young man in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Oh God, oh God, oh God, stir us again. Speak to us again, Lord. Let there be a fresh anointing. Glory to God. Glory, 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 glory to God. Glory to God. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Let your anointing fall fresh upon your servant. Use him for your glory, your honor, and your praise. Let the name of Jesus Christ. Oh God. Right now I commend you to God and to the word of his grace, which is able to build you up and give you an inheritance among them that are sanctified. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ be with all of his people now and evermore. And all the people say, and all the people say, and all the people say, God bless, God bless, God bless. Shibo.
God.